गिरिधारी कृष्ण मुरारी, हे गिरिधारी कृष्ण मुरारी, गोवर्धन गिरिधारी प्रभो हरि, गोवर्धन गिरिधारी प्रभो हरि, गोवर्धन गिरिधारी प्रभो हरि, हे गिरिधारी कृष्ण मुरारी, हे गिरिधारी कृष्ण गोवर्धन गिरिधारी प्रभो संहारी भव भय हारी,
पाप संहारी
पाप संहारी भव भय हारी, पतजन मन रक्षक कारी, पाप संहारी भव भय हारी, पाप संहारी भक्त जन मन रक्षक कारी, जय राधे श्याम मुकुंद मुरारी, जय राधे श्याम मुकुंद
मुरारी,
जय मीरा प्रभो हृदय विहारी, जय राधे श्याम मुकुंद मुरारी, जय राधे श्याम मुकुंद मुरारी, जय मीरा प्रभो हृदय विहारी, जय राधे श्याम मुकुंद मुरारी, जय मीरा प्रभु हृदय बिहारी, जय मीरा प्रभु हृदय विहारी, मुकुंद मुरारी हृदय विहारी, मुकुंद मुरारी हृदय विहारी, मुकुंद मुरारी हृदय विहारी, बिहारी मुकुंद मुरारी हृदय 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 बिहारी मुकुंद मुरारी मुकुंद मुरारी हृदय बिहारी 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 मुकुंद मुरारी हृदय मुकुंद मुरारी हृदय बिहारी 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 गिरिधारी कृष्ण मुरारी
गिरिधारी कृष्ण मुरारी
शांताकारं भुजगशयनं पद्मनाभं सुरेशं विश्वाधारं गगनसदृशं मेघवर्णं शुभांगं लक्ष्मीकांतं कमलनयनं योगिभिर्ध्यानगम्यं वंदे विष्णुं भवभयहरं सर्वलोकैकनाथं सच्चिदानंदरूपाय विश्वोत्पत्यादिहेतवे तापत्रय विनाशाय श्रीकृष्णाय वयं नमः गुष्यते यस्य नगरे रंगयात्रा दिने नहि तमहं शिरसा वंदे राजानं कुलशेखरं वंदे मुकुंदवरविंददलायताक्षं कुंदेन्दुशंखदशनं शिशुगोपवेशं इंद्रादिदेवगणवंदितपादपीठं वृंदावनालयमहं वसुदेवसूनुं श्रीवल्लभेदि वरदेदि दयापरेदि भक्त प्रियेदि बबलुं तनको हितेदि नाथेदि नागशयनेदि जगन्निवासेदि मालापनं प्रतिपदं कुरु मां मुकुंद जयतु जयतु देवो देवकी नंदनोयम् जयतु जयतु पृथ्वी प्रदीपः जयतु जयतु मेघश्यामल कोमलाङ्गः जयतु जयतु पृथ्वी भारनाशो मुकुन्दः मुकुन्दमूर्ध्ना प्रणिपत्य याचे भवन्तमेकान्तमियन्तमर्थम् अविस्मृतिस्वच्चरणारविन्दे भवे भवे मेस्तु भवत्प्रसादात् नाहं वन्दे तव चरणयोर्द्वन्द्वमद्वन्द्वहेतो पुण्डीपाकं गुरुमपि हरे नारकं नापनेतुं रम्या रामा मृदुतनुलता नन्दनेनापि रन्तुं भावे भावे हृदय भवने भावयेयं भवन्तम् नास्ताधर्मे नवसु निचये नैव कामोपभोगे यद्यद्भाव्यं भवतु भगवन् पूर्वकर्मानुरूपम् एतत्प्राप्त्यं मम बहुमतं जन्म जन्मान्तरेऽपि त्वत्पादाम्बोरुहयुगगता निश्चला भक्तिरस्तु दिवि वा भुवि वा ममास्तु वासः नरके वा नरकान्तकप्रकामम् अवधीरितशारदारविन्दौ चरणोते मरणीपि चिन्तयानि कृष्णत्वदीयपदपङ्कजपञ्चरान्तः अद्यैव मे विशदु मानसराजहंसः प्राणप्रयाणसमये कपपादपित्तैः घण्टावरोदनविदौ स्मरणं कुतस्ते चिन्तयामि हरिमेव सन्ततं मन्दमन्दहसिताननाम्बुजम् नन्दगोपतनयं परात्परं नारदादिमुनिवृन्दवन्दितं सरसिजनयने सशङ्खचक्रे मुरपिदिमा विरमस्वचित्तरन्तुं सुखकरमपरं न जातु जाने हरिचरणस्मरणामृतेन तुल्यम् I do not see anything more joy-giving than remembrance of Bhagavan's lotus feet. Hari charana smarana amrutena tulyam nat sukakaram aparam jane. I do not see anything that is more joy-giving than this. In Bhagavad Gita and many other places, we see that joy of life is said to be a product of peace. Ashantasya kutasukam, it is said. A mind which is not peaceful, where is the question of happiness? That is why Krishna says, prasade sarva dukkanam hani rasyo upajayate prasanna chetaso hyashu buddhi paryavatishtati नास्ति बुद्धिरयुक्तस्य न चायुक्तस्य भावना न चाभावयतः शान्तिः अशान्तस्य कुतः सुखम् इफ् वी मीट लाइफ विद् द प्रसाद बुद्धि प्रसाद मीन्स् प्रग्रशेन सीदति इति प्रसादः इन् संस्कृत सद् सीदति मीन्स् दट् विच् सिट्स् आसन् यु नो आसीद मीन्स् सिट् डाउन सद् मीन्स् टु सिट् Satsidati. That when the mind settles down completely with no oscillation, that is called prasad. So prasad is not what you receive from, you know, the prasad you give, they give after the end of the puja. That also should be received with a grace. You know, this is the Lord's grace that is given to me. Don't look at it and say, you got more than mine. You know, then it is not prasad. Don't compare. Prasad means whatever comes to you, that is prasad. In Punjabi, they say prasad. Prasad. And mind, when it become having that prasad, what is become prasanna? Mind becomes tranquil. So prasade, in that prasada buddhi, buddho, in that mind which is tranquil, sarva dukkhanam hani, where the elimination of all sorrows. Prasanna chetaso hyashu buddhi paryavatishtati. That such a mind which has received everything as a grace of the Lord becomes quiet. And a quiet mind alone can really meditate. Na asti buddhi ayuktasya na cha ayuktasya bhavana. A mind which is oscillating and disturbing can never settle down for meditation. Na cha bhavayada shantihi. When a mind is not meditating, where is the question of peace? Ashantasya kutasukam. Where is the joy for a person who's mind is not at peace? So going back in that later, what we find? Prasada buddhi is sukham. Mind which has received everything as a grace is joyful. Now let us look at the logic behind this. What is sukham? In Sanskrit, the word kham means space. Kham means space. When there is a space here where say 100, 200 people can sit, if there are 500 people, what is your condition? Dukkham. No space. Like electric train in Bombay, you know. What is dukkham? Why? There is no space. When there are 100 people, 200 people can sit, only 10 people are there. Sukham. Why? Sushtukham. A lot of space. Just like the externally, when we are in a congested situation where we find so much of unhappiness and there is enough space, there is joy, so also in our head. When the mind is free of thoughts or free, less number of thoughts are there, sukham. When it is crowded with too many thoughts, dukkham. So what is sukakaram? What is the most joyful state where the mind has nothing else other than the Lord? Sukha karam aparam na jato jane. I do not know anything else that can give me most joyful, most joy. What? Hari charana smarana amruti na tulyam. Tulyam sadrasham. That which is equal to, that which is a remembrance of the lotus feet of the Lord, which is amrutas, amrutaswarupam, amrutatulyam. The feet of the Lord, meaning the very Lord who is the very sustainer of the entire universe, if I have in Him in my mind, where is the question of anything else that will come and disturb me? Sukha karama param na jato jane hari charana smarana mrutena tulyam. So remembrance of the Lord is going to say next verse is the most easy thing. You know, let us see the next verse. And ma viramasma chittarantum, in this verse says murabidi ma viramasma, don't forget. Hey chitta rantum ma viramasva, do not ever forget to revel in the Lord. Ram ramana means to revel, not the other ram. Ram ramanam means to revel in the Lord. Ram yade ramade sarvatin ramat sarvasmin ramade idi ramah. Rama is none other than one who revels in the heart of everyone. Jaha Ram hai, maha kaam nahi. Jaha kaam hai, maha Ram nahi. Where Ramana, the Lord is there, Rama, then there cannot be any kama. But if kama has come inside, then there is no Ram. Is it not true? Kaikeyi was so jubilant when she heard that Rama is going to be coronated. And she was all like anybody else. She was so happy. She was joyful and distributing sweets, etc. And when Mantara came and said, did you hear that Rama is going to be coronated? Of course I know. Here is a chain for you. Here is a necklace for you. Here is a... keep it with yourself. I have not come here to take these things from you. Then, I want to remind you one thing. What? When Rama becomes the king or the Yuvaraj, Kausalya becomes the Rani, or the main queen and not you. Yes, you will be secondary or tertiary queen only, that is all it is. And Rama's best person is, best friend is, or best brother is Lakshmana. And so, who? Sumitra will become the second, you will be third. That is all I want to say. See, that poison has been put in the heart of Kaikeyi. That's why you have to be careful about whom you are talking to or who is your close associate, because they can poison your head. So then when she heard this, and then she said, ever Rama will be the Yuvraj, and then Bharat will be his assistant or maybe a servant. That is all. And you will be servant of Kausalya. That is all it is. Narayana, Narayana. She didn't say Narayana. That is Narada's job. So suddenly she realized, what should I do now? Stop. Stop the whole process. How? He said, you remember that you had two boons? Ask for it. Now see, when the Kama has come, Rama has to go. Dasharatha, on the other hand, he could have said, no. No, I don't want to listen to you. I would go by what I have decided. Even in his mind, he had a Kama for Kaikeyi more than anybody else. Therefore, Kam Agaya, so Ram chal gaya. In Sitaji's case also there, where she was in the forest after so many years of living with Rama, and one day a golden deer appeared there. Oh dear, dear, I want the deer. So the deer Rama has disappeared, and the deer becomes more important. See, when Kama has come, Rama has to go. So that is why it is said here, O my mind, hey Chitta, ma viramasmarantum, do not ever forget to revel in the thought of the Lord. Sukakaramaparam najatu janihi murabidi ma viramasma chittarantum. Hey, one who has destroyed a mura. Murari is also known as Murasya Hari or Murabid, destroyer of Mura. The demon, one who has. Mura means what? The meaning of Mura means one who occupies you. Literal meaning of Mura is one who envelops, occupies you. Is it not that our mind gets occupied with so many other things, and the Lord's thought alone can really destroy that? So if you want to revel in the name of the Lord, one thing we need to do is destroy the preoccupations of the mind. Why do we take up the name of the Lord? It is also another form of thinking only. But that thinking removes all other thinking. When you take the name of the Lord, Vishnu, Vishnu, Vashatkaro, Bhuta, Bhavya, Bhavat, Prabhu, Bhuta, Krut, Bhuta, Prut, Bhavo, Bhutatma, Bhuta, Bhavana, Bhutatma Paramatma cha Nimuttanam Paramagatihi. When you take the name of the Lord and continue, in the beginning stages it may look very mechanical. But only you start remembering the name of the Lord along with its meaning, it will be so sweetening and so beautiful, and your mind will get fully absorbed in that. When I was very small, I was taken to this place at the temple every day by my parents, and we have to chant Vishnu Sahasranam. I used to protest. My parents were very clear. If you don't chant, no dinner. So dinner. That was on the background of my mind going on. Vishnu Vashnava Shatkaro Bhuda Bhavyavad Prahut Prabhu Bhuda Prudhpada Bhattava Bhudatma. All the eating and chanting, all those things were coming into my mind. But they mechanically were chanting. But only after going to Sandipani and realize that how important that samskara that was given to me, right? So when while reading the meaning, I don't need to remember anything else. I just remember the word and the meaning, word and the meaning, word and the meaning. Because the word already I know. Because it has been already there in the system. Now only the meaning I have to remember. So it is mind which is thus able to occupy itself. You know, when Gurudev was small, when he was, it is there in his biography, you will read, that when he was very small, He was a playful boy, you know, he was going around playing like any other boy. His mother was not there, so his aunt were the ones who were growing him up. And every Monday they used to have a particular, you know, ritual of worship of Lord Shiva. 2-3 hours of worship, more than that. And like you have here, started around 7:30, it goes up to 9. And there it is more elaborately they do. So the aunts were very particular. You must sit and watch the puja that is going on. And he used to protest. No, I don't want to. You must sit. No food for you. Okay. He would sit there and watch. Then he was getting bored. So one day he decided, why not I just try to capture the form of Shiva into my mind? There's no other things he could do then. So he was looking at the form of the Lord. He was Lord Shiva sitting in deep meditation, Ganga Jatadhari, and then the Ganges flowing down, huge matted locks, and then Tripunda, that is a very Tripundra, where is the Bhasma is there all over the body, and then third eye, and then neck is full of all the snakes everywhere, but no other ornament, only snakes everywhere. And then Trishula in the side, behind there is Himachal there, and next to him is Nandi was sitting there and wearing only the skin of the tiger, blue complexion with a white complexion, the blue neck, and deep in meditation, Rudrakshamal, and all those descriptions, he will look at form of the Lord and close his eyes and try to recall everything that he would see, he would have seen there, from top to bottom, all the various things that he. And by the time he finishes the, come to the bottom of the picture, again the first top will be forgotten. I can open the eyes, look at the whole thing, close the eyes, remember the whole thing. So he used to do it as a mere joyful play. In fact, Bhagavan Shankaracharya has written, Shiva Padadi Keshanta Varnanam, Vishnu Padadi Keshanta Varnanam, description of the Lord from the feet up to the head. So why that is important? For meditation, upasana, that is called Drishyanuvidya Savikalpa Samadhi. Drishtanuvidya or Drishyanuvidya Savikalpa Samadhi. Meaning, along with the thoughts with associated with the form. That is the one form of Samadhi. So that is prescribed as a methodology, method of bringing the mind to the bare minimum thoughts. So he used to practice that unknowingly. And he writes, I mean, in this biography we've seen, even after he went to the university, etc., where he got occupied with so many other things, whenever he closed his eyes, he remembered the form. You know, at the end of the day, when he is lying down, the moment he would close his eyes, the Lord will appear. What a wonderful thing. You close your eyes, what comes? So we can practice remembering the Lord. That is the reason you must have only one form, which is the main deity of your, you know, meditation. You may have all other things, but main deity should be one which you meditate on. Don't keep changing. Monday Shiva, Tuesday Ganesha, Wednesday Krishna, and Thursday Guru, and Friday Lakshmi, and Saturday Hanuman, and Sunday Chutti, and all those things. One form of the Lord which you remember is a heart, and in the very heart of your own being, and that is the Ishta Devata. And once you intensely remember that form alone in your mind, even while you're doing the puja to that deity, and as you close your eyes and capture that form of the Lord, remembering the name of the Lord, chanting the name of the Lord continuously when you practice, wherever you are, whatever you do, you close your eyes, the Lord will be there. So that is what he was practicing there. And here, He Chitta Rantum Ma Viramasva. Do not forget to revel Sarasi Janayane Sashanka Chakri. Sa Shankha Chakra, Gurudev used to explain. Shankha means conch. The conch is necessary for those people who are able to listen to the call of the Lord. he reminds us, your final goal is moksha. Remember that anything else that you do is only merely relative plane only, but your absolute goal is moksha. That's why he blows the conch. If you don't listen to him, chakra will come. Chakra means you will get into the chakra. Samsara chakra. You will get into that whirlpool of moving continuously. So, Sa Shankha Chakra, the Lord is along with the conch and the disc. Sarasi Janayane Sa Shankha Chakre Muravidiva Viravasma Chittarantam Sukha Karma Param Najatu Jane Hari Charana Smaranamrutena Tulyam. So again addressing his mind, he says, Ma Bir Mandamano Vichintya Bahudha Yami Stiram Yatana. Namina Prabhavanti Paparibhavah Swami Nanu Sridharah. Alasyam Vyapaniya Bhakti Sulabham Dhyaya Svanarayanam Lokasya Vyasanapano Dhanakaro. Dasasya Kim Nakshamah Mabir Mandamano Vichintya Bahudayami Stiram Yatana Namina Prabhavanti Paparibhavah Swami Nanu Sridharah. Alasyam Vyapaniya Bhakti Sulabham Dhyayasvanarayanam Lokasya Vyasanapano Dhanakaro Dhasasya Kim Nakshamah. Hey Manah, oh my mind, Mabhi, don't be afraid. Mabhi, hey Mandamana, oh my dull-witted mind. Mind is dull-witted. Alert nature of the mind is very rare to find. Most of the time mind is dull. Because it has to have some kind of a desire to get excited. In general, it is dull. Especially children, early morning get up. I am bored. I am tired. Early morning. Hey, my mind is dull-witted. Hey, mandamana, ma bhihi. Vayam nakuryat, may you not have fear. Why? About what? Yatanaha, all the suffering, yamis chiram yatanaha, bahuta. It is too far, too much of suffering. Where? Yami, yamasyalaye. Yami means the abode of Yama. Chiram yatanaha, a long time of suffering due to all the things that we have done in the past. Don't you mind worry about or be afraid about how long we have to suffer the results of actions in the hell, the abode of Yama. Na ami paparibhavaha prabhavanti. Naha prabhavanti. For us, Ami Papa Ribavaha, Ripu means the enemies called Papas. The sinful enemies don't ever touch us. Don't worry about it. Why? Swami Nanu Sridharaha, is it not the Lord is there with you? You see, in Bhagavatam also there is a character called Ajamila. Nice person to start with, but he had done very sinful things, very bad things in his life. But one thing good he did was, he gave the name of the Lord to his son. Only one thing. You know, we are also very bad by nature. Sometimes we do good things also. So that is what we think we have. Highlight only that. If I ask, are you good or bad? In general, I am bad. Sometimes I do good things. And whatever we do, good things only, we talk about it to others. Anything bad, you go and tell them, I see, you know, I shouted at him, you know, so much. And I hate him. He's cruel. I am a criminal. Nobody says that. I give this donation to here and I did this. Everything good we tell everybody in the world. So this Ajamila did only one thing good. Gave the name of the Lord to his son, Narayan. And it is said that when he was about to die, his deathbed, all the kinkaras of the Yamas, they came to take his body away, take his, like, not body, the life away, the soul. As they came there and about to get him, at that time, Narayana Dutas, Vishnu Dutas also came there. And they had a conversation. And he was aware of that. What is going on? Because the last moment of his life, when he was about to leave, he said, Narayana, he called his son only. And as soon as he called the name of the Lord, immediately the Lord dispatched, come on, go. So Vishnu Dutas came there, and then they saw Yamadutas already landing there. So he landed quite fast there. Then they stopped. Stop there. And why? Because he called us. He called the Lord, and Lord has sent us. So you cannot touch them. So it's like it's FBI and CIA, you know, they have they constantly fight with each other. Whose authority is this? In the same way, both of them started having conversations. In the conversation, they said, anybody who has even last moment uttered once the name of the Lord, such a person will be released from all the sins. Don't say, okay, last moment I will think about it. You can remember only that which you have been remembering all the time. Earlier also we saw that. That's what he said earlier. What is that he said? I forgot. Chintayami harime vasantatam manda manda hasitana nambujam Nanda Gopatanayam Parat Param Naradati Muni Brinda Vanditam Krishna Tvadiya Pada Pangaja Pancharantaha Adhivami Vishadumana Sarajaham Saha Prana Prayana Samayi Kapavada Pittaihi Kanta Varodana Vido Smaranam Kutaste. Let my mind enter right now. I do not want to waste even one moment. Next moment I do not know. When we have become senile and, you know, we are not able to think, we cannot even walk properly, at that time, how do you think? Body will take most of your attention. Every part of the body will start making noise. And everything is screwed and nutted and bolted. Everywhere it is only metal things that is there. So at that time, how will you remember the Lord? You become a senior citizen. You know, you was a senior citizen who want to see everything near. It's called senior. At that time, how are you going to see? You know, one person was playing golf and he came back home and said, I'm done. He said to his wife, what happened? I can't even see where the ball is going. How do I even go anywhere? I hit and then I don't know where it is gone. I'm 80. Remember, you understand, I cannot play anymore. So wife said, why not you take my brother with you? He has a very good eyesight. He is 90, I know that. But he has a very good eyesight. Okay, I'll take him. The next day, he was with his brother-in-law. He hit. Did you see where it go? Ah, yeah, I can see clearly. Very good. Where did it go? I forgot. I can see, but I forgot. So when you are in that condition, what do you remember? The body takes over all your attention. Every part of the body is in tension. So when the physical body is weak, mind is so dull, other faculties have become so depleted. Oh, why? What can he remember at that time? So harimeva santadam chintayami adyevameva shu. So he says, if only you remember that Lord Swami nanu sridharaha na ami paparibhavaha prapavanti naha. They don't touch us. Therefore, alasyam vyapaniya. Leave your laziness. Alsi madbanam. Alasya means, Sanskrit means, alasya means lazy. Nowadays, in their serving the food also, there is one in front, in the middle of them. Alsi Chakra, I call that as Lazy Susan. Even to serve there, they keep it there and zzz, it goes. And then, I wonder if this also goes on. Now, I'm meeting. Hey, what's happened? Mine is there. That doesn't move. At least the friend, only in the middle it goes. So, that's called Alsi Chakra. Alasyam vyapaniya. Please leave your laziness. Oh, so chant the name of the Lord. What you need to do? Anything to be done? Anything to be done at all? In fact, you don't need to have viveka, vairagya, satsampatti, mumukshutvam. For this, no such qualification at all necessary. Swamiji, you should have said, long time back, I've been studying Judamani, Gita, Upanishad, Tattvabodh, Atmabodh, Vajagovindam, nothing. Bhakti sulabham dhyayasva narayanam. It is so simple. Just remember the name of the Lord. Can there be more easier than this? But we lack faith. We don't believe. And therefore, to convince our stupid intellect, we need all these things. Logic is not necessary for the man of faith. Ramakrishna Paramahams, Mirabai, Surdas, Tulsidas, Kanagadas. What did they study? How long, Saponji Maharaj, how many years he went to the school? Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, I don't think he has gone beyond third grade or fourth grade. So what was there in their heart? Faith. Simple faith. Innocent faith. Our Gurudev will say, we the university educated filtered idiots, we are to be told. Finally, the end result of all the study of the scriptures and listening is faith. Shraddhavan lapate jnanam tatparasayatendriyah jnanam ladva param shantim machirenadi gacchati. Shraddhavan labhate jnanam. Only person of faith will gain knowledge. All the study we have done, there is no faith. That's why if you see Kaivalya Upanishad, when the student asks, please teach me about Brahman, he says, Shraddha bhakti jnana yoga avaihi. You come to know that by faith, devotion and meditation. Yoya shraddha saye vasaha. Krishna also says, whatever your faith is, you will become that. If that faith is not there, then we are victim of fate. Faith alone can replace fate. Or fate is replaced only by faith. So that Shraddha, simple belief is not there. We are so much in a rational that, I want this, I want. See, the logic also has got its own peculiar things. I read in some paper, 90% of the accidents, out of 90% of the accidents, 10% of accidents are caused by drinking and driving. 10% of the accidents are because of drinking and driving. So 90% is without drinking. Therefore, what you should do? Now, if this is a logic.
Logic can be interpreted any way you want. So drink. Only 10% chance you have. If you don't drink, 90% chance is there that you will be killed. It's, logic is clear. That's why Upanishad very clearly says, by logic you don't try to reach that. It's not possible. नैषा तर्केण मदिरापनेया न एषा मदि तर्केण आपनेया दिस कैनॉट बी गेन्ड बाय रैशनल थिंकिंग बाय वाद एंड प्रतिवाद एंड तर्क यू कैनॉट रीच देयर बिकॉज इट इज बियॉन्ड द स्कोप ऑफ लॉजिक नॉट टू प्रूव दैट यू आर अलाइव व्हाट यू शुड डू व्हाट यू शुड डू यू प्रूव दैट यू आर अलाइव टेल मी नाउ हाउ विल यू प्रूव दैट यू आर अलाइव I am talking to you, I am walking to you. That is all body is doing. How would you say that you are alive? Life cannot be seen. I can only appreciate your life because I am alive. That's all it is. I am alive and therefore I can appreciate that you are alive. Correct? So that which is invisible, agochara vastu, atindriya vastu, cannot be proved by any logic. In the Pramana Viveka also it is very clearly said, only Shabda Pramana will take you there. Only the teaching and the teacher and the words of the scripture alone can take you there, not any other thing. In Gyana Upanishad also student teacher says, I do not know how to teach you. Because only way I can teach you is how I was taught. That which is beyond the mind, yato vacho nivartante aprapya manasasaha. It cannot be spoken by words, the mind cannot reach there. So what logic you can use? So here one must have the simple innocent faith, love for the Lord. And that cannot be a product of any rational thinking. So here it is, alasyam vyapaniya, leave all your laziness. Bhakti sulabham, it is available for everyone, whether it is educated, uneducated, literate or illiterate. There is no other qualification, just love the Lord. That is all the qualification. And love, everybody knows. Nobody in this world, first day itself I said, there is nobody in this world who does not know the language of love. Bhakti sulabham dhyayasva narayanam. And believe that the Lord, when you think of, He will protect you. Because He says in this world, you are He, the Lord, who can remove everybody's affliction. Can't He not remove your affliction, you the servant of the Lord? Lokasya vyasana apanodhanakaraha. Apanodhanakaraha means one who removes. Lokasya vyasana, the afflictions of the world, whole world, he can remove. Dasasya kim nakshamaha. Is he not possible for him to remove the afflictions of his own servant, his own dasa? Ma bir mandamano vichintya bahuta yamis chiram yatana. नामीन प्रभवन्ति पापरिभवः स्वामीन अनुश्रीधरः आलस्यं व्यपनीय भक्ति सुलभं ध्यायस्व नारायणं लोकस्य व्यसनापनोदनकरो दासस्य किं न क्षमः. Remember when Bhagavan was in the Vaikuntha, he was lying down. Sanat Kumaras came there. Sanaka, Sanadana, Sanandana, Sanat Kumaras. When they came, they wanted direct entry because they have, you know, international passport. They were about to enter the Vaikuntha. Then Bhagavan was taking rest or whatever. So the Jaya Vijaya were standing outside. Said, stop! They didn't even first look at them because they were so small. They were standing like this. We want to go. Who is that? What is the song? Did you hear any song? Yes, there. Two, four of them. You want to get in? Where? To the abode of the Lord. He's taking rest. You can't go. How dare you? We have entry everywhere. Brahmaputraha. Brahmanaha putraha. We can go anywhere. Not possible. How dare you say not possible? Then this is, the rishis have only two things. Curse or purse. Either they curse or they open the purse. So immediately they pronounced, you two people become demons in the whole world, in the world. Gora. They got so afraid. Then hearing this sound, some chaos going on, Bhagavan himself came out and what is going on? Jay and Vijay, they cursed us. What happened? What did you do? We didn't allow them. I told them, these are special entries, VIPs. You can, always they can, but you know, we didn't know that they have the VIP because we didn't even see them first. So, they are only the size of the card. We cannot even look at what card they have. So then, Bhagavan saluted the Sanat Kumar, said, please forgive. They made a mistake. So when Lord himself, he says, my servant, I am responsible. What their behavior is my behavior. So you plus, please forgive. And they were so moved. Bhagavan is asking for forgiveness. So he said, because you have cursed them, because they have to go down and suffer as demons, I will also go down to save them. This is the reason why they came as Hiranyaksha, Hiranyakashipu, Ravana and Kumbhakarna, and Kamsa as Jayatra, and Jayatrada or Vishishupala, one of them. One of them. Don't need to remember all the wicked people anyway. So he came himself to protect them, to save them. So Dasasya Kim Nakshamaha, if you are his servant, will he not do that? If he can remove everybody's problem, will he not? So by you chanting the name of the Lord, you are already in his abode. It is said there are four kinds of these mokshas are possible. One is Sarupya, Samipya, Salokya and Sayujya. First one is Sarupya, you taking his form. Meaning, when you are meditating upon the Lord, you are already assuming his form. Shivo Bhutva Shivam Yajet. When you are worshipping the Lord Shiva, you must look like Shiva. Meaning, you also wear the all those things which Shiva wears. Rudraksha and snakes and all you wouldn't put. But anyway, you put Vibhuti. Why? Because Shivo Bhutva Shivam Yajet. You must assume his form. Similarly, when you are worshipping Narayana, then what Narayana is wearing is the Nama. And why do they put that? Because only you take the Sarupya, his form you take, and then you invoke him. So when you say that, Abhahyami Devesham Adhimantyandavajjaram Adharam Sarvalokanam Ashtidartha Pranayinam. When you are touching your heart and putting your hand on the feet of the Lord or the whatever, Vishnu, Swaligrahama or Vishivalinga, you are already invoking the Lord from your heart who is already residing there into that form. So you are invoking him. So that is Sarupya. Then you enter into that abode of the Lord, Sarupya Moksha, and then comes Salokya. Or Samipya, that is interchangeable. Salokya or Samipya. Salokya means you get into the abode of the Lord, and Samipya means you go up to the proximity of the Lord. Samipa. Only when you have lost your ego becomes Sayujya, meaning merge with him. So uttering the name of the Lord, you are in his abode already. Where the Lord's name is chanted continuously, you have already gone to his abode. Then worshipping the deities or devotees of the Lord, you have come closer to his being. and assuming his nature and losing your ego, you will become him. So alasyam vyapaniya, leave your laziness. Bhakti sulabham, it is so easy. Dhyayasva narayanam, remember the Lord. Then if you have become his dasa, what he do you have any calamity afterwards at all? One Advaita master was telling his student, you know, remember the supreme truth and chant soham, soham, soham. He is me, he is me, he is me. Chant that. This fellow was sitting there. Soham, 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 soham. Then one other guru came by. What? You're chanting soham? He is a Dvaita master. A person who believes in dualistic worship. You can never be him. You can only his servant. Therefore, add da before that. Dasoham, dasoham, dasoham. So he chanted dasoham, dasoham. No, first master came back. Servant? You are not a servant. You are him. You are always him. Therefore, add sa before that. Sadasoham, sadasoham, sadasoham. The second master came. You are not fit to be his friend, servant. You are only fit to be his servant of the servant. Therefore, da, add one more. Dasa dasoham, dasa dasoham. It never ends. It goes on like that. So, before you become soham, you have become dasoham. You should be. Dasa means one who is ready to serve the Lord in whichever capacity he puts. Whichever state you are, you must serve anybody, you serve as though you are serving the Lord. That's why in Ramayana at the end, towards the end of Ramayana, we find when Bhagavan Sri Rama was asking in Valmiki Ramayana, what is our relationship between you and me, Hanuman? Hanumanji beautifully says, when I look at you, this is what comes to my mind. Deha buddhya dasoham. From the standpoint of my body, I am only your servant. Jiva buddhya tvadam shakaha. From the standpoint of being a soul, I am only a part of you. Atma buddhya tvamevaham. From the standpoint of the self, I am you. Iti me nischita matihi. This is my understanding. So long as we are identified with the body, dasa. Because, as we saw in the 12th chapter also, it is not possible for anyone to worship the abstract nature of the Lord so long as we are identified with the body. This body identification is there, we cannot recognize our formless, nameless nature. Kleshaha adhikatarastesham avyakta sakta chetasam avyakta hi gadihi dukkham deha vadbhirava. Dehavadbihi avyakta gatihi dukkham avapyate. Dukkhena avapyate. It is very difficult to get that abstract nature of the Lord so long as I am identified with this body. So, deha buddhya dasaha evaham. We are only the servant of the Lord so long as I consider myself as this physical body. So, what I can do, this body itself is given to me as a blessing. With this, let me serve him. So we are all fit to be his servant, dasa. That's why he says, if you remember the Lord and become his servant, he will take care of you for sure. Deha buddhya dasoham jiva buddhya tvad amshakah. From the standpoint of jiva, a living soul, I am only a particle of yours. Atma buddhya tvamevaham. From the standpoint of being the self, I am you. There is no difference. Iti me nischita matihi. This is my understanding. So in our present day context, we see Advaita was taught by Shankaracharya. Immediately followed by him was Ramanujacharya, he talked about Amsha Amshi Bhava. That is Vishishta Advaita. Then Madhvacharya came and said Dvaitam. They are not three different schools. No doubt it appears to be so. But three different stages. Start becoming a Dasa. Then you understand you are his Amsha. And then become Advaita. All great masters, including our own Gurudev, why did he create all the temples? Why did he create all this tradition of worshipping in the temples, etc. everywhere? Because let us begin with loving the Lord as an external form. Then slowly understand you are his own being, your own, his own vertical expression, and then you become one with him. So therefore, here says, if you can remember him, that is the most easy. Alasyam vyapaniya bhakti sulabham dhyayasva narayanam lokasya vyasanapano dhanakaro dasasya kim nakshamah. Now, we may say that, you know, yes, I understand that I should remember the Lord. To be in his proximity, to get his grace, etc. But Swamiji, we are all grihasthis. Grihastha means you are householder. Meaning you are holding on to the house. You are householder. Like a, you know, pencil holder, pen holder, a householder. Holding on to the house. House is not holding on to you. You are holding on to the house. What to do? One person came to Bhagavan Ramana, Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. He said, I want to take up sannyas, but what to do? You know, my parents, children are there and there, and then my business is there, and I have to make my children ready to take over the business. Other than that, I cannot just leave it and come to you. I cannot take sannyas just like that. You must remember that. Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, he looked at him and smiled. At that time, one young student of that ashram, he ran and they held on to a tree and held on to it very tightly. Ah, please, somebody leave me from this tree. Tree is holding on to me. Oh, the tree is holding on to me. So this man looked at him. Is he your disciple? Yes. Why is he so foolish? He said, what is foolishness? How can the tree hold him? What foolishness? He is as fool or little less foolish than you. How can the business hold on to you? How can the house hold on to you? You are holding on to it. When you start releasing, they become independent of you. We are afraid to leave. That is the problem. We think we are the general manager of this world. That's our problem. You know, without me, nothing will happen. Go out and see. Everything wonderfully will go on. Nobody is indispensable in this world. Nobody. Before you, it was good. After you, it will be better. Because don't think that you are the only one who is doing everything. We think that we are indispensable. I have to be there. Without me, nothing will happen. Everything will happen better. Now we hold on to, we are afraid because we are insecure. One lady came to me and said, Swamiji, I am ready for moksha. Except the point is what? You know, what will happen to my husband if I leave? That is the only concern I have. Otherwise, I am ready for moksha. So we have the fear that we will be forgotten. Let's say even if you sell a house, you know, and go to another part of the city, and once in a while you go that side. How are they giving my house? Are they painting it or not? Cleaning it or not? We, after even given up the house also, we cannot leave that. You know, it is like if somebody gives you a gift, you know, somebody gives you a gift. After giving the gift, you should not ask what happened to that. Next day, you know, what have you done with that gift? What's your problem? He might have given, written back to the same shop only I got some money out of it or something else I bought. Why do you ask that question? But if you are asking the question, then you have not given at all. So physically the material got moved, but mentally you are still holding on to it. Once you are given, given, that's all. Don't even look back at that. Whatever you do with that. Similarly, when you give your child or a husband, your daughter, your son to your son-in-law, done. Chalo, you tum le lo. I am done. Nothing. Mera beta, mera botha, my grandchild, my great grandchild. Go on, 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 on. Never ending story. It is. One lady, you know, she got married and came. Then Madanga said, now you are the boss. You are the, you know, you take care of everything now. I am done. I have done all these years. I have done all this cooking, eating, everything now. It's up to you. Within an year also, I am going to Kashi Kshetra. I am done with this. Okay. Only thing is, I just want to make sure that you do everything right. You may not know my taste of my son. So once you learn, you know, I will tell you what are the things he likes and all. I will train you after that. She was very happy. Mother-in-law is, you know. She was waiting for 1 year. By the time she got pregnant. You know. So she said, mother-in-law said, you know, you will be very difficult for you to do all the work until the child is born. Let me see the child and then I'll go. The child was born and she was got busy with the child. So mother-in-law was taking care another 2-3 years. I want to see the child going to school, you know. I want to see how, son, you are busy, you cannot teach him many things. I will teach him all this language and other things, prayers, etc. Daughter-in-law said, no, I can teach him. You don't know. So the child was born, then he was taking care, and then he was started going to school. So she was teaching him, and then he, 10 years, you know. Then afterwards, the husband, the daughter-in-law said, now he's going to college. Okay? I think it's high time. You must find your ways to. Child has gone to college does not mean the family will stop. I want to see him in another few years, he'll get married. I want to see that in a few years only. Anyway, he got graduated and got married. He came and said, now you do not know how to be a mother-in-law, I will teach you. It never ends. We just do not know how to let go. It is said in our Shastra, the moment you see the face of your first grandchild, quit. That's called Vanaprastha. Vanaprasthanam, yes, yeah. Vanaprasthana means go to the forest. Well, go to the forest means go in. There is no forest, Swamiji, now where do we go? Go for rest. It's called going for rest. Go for rest. Meaning, there is no more, you must interfere with what is going on there. Anyway, the point is we just cannot give up. Hold on, hold on. It's a householder. So you may say, I'm a householder, Swamiji. What can I do? Here, see, the next verse is so beautiful. Bhava jaladhigatanam dvandva vata hatanam suta duhitru kalatra trana bhararditanam vishama vishayato ye majjatam aplavanam bhavatu sharanameko Vishnu poto narana Bhava jaladigatanam dundvavata hatanam sudadu hitru kalatra trana bharartitanam Vishama vishayato ye majjatam aplavanam Bhavatu sharanameko Vishnu poto naranam. Naranam Vishnu potaha ekam eva sharanam. Eka bhavatu sharanam ekaha. Only one resort that we all have is a boat called Vishnu. Potha in Sanskrit means boat. Potha. Vishnu Potha Naranam Bhavatu Ekam Sharanam. There's only resort for a householder that is there is a boat called Vishnu. Because we are right in the middle of the ocean. Bhava Jaladi. Jaladi means ocean. Bhava, the worldliness, samsara, samsara sagare. Bhava Jaladi Gatanam. Those who have gone into this huge ocean. Why it's called referred to the ocean? Because the beginning and end we don't know. Depth also we don't know. It is said that one ship got wrecked and everybody is thrown out and crying and when everybody was lamenting there, they do not know what to have, what everything is broken. So then one fellow was going around and then he asked captain, hey, how far is the land from here? 2 kilometers. That's all. I'm a swimming champion. And he went around the boat and then he said, which direction? He said, below. The land is 1-2 miles below there. Because this side is, you cannot see the beginning. It's this side you cannot see the beginning. There is no shore anywhere. That is called samsara. Where you know where it begins? Where does it end? How far it is? How many lives you have come? How much to go? No idea. That's called samsara sagara. Bhava jaladi gatana. And it is not only that you are in the middle of the ocean with no boat, obviously. And there is a huge wind blowing there. Dvandva vata hatana. What is that wind that is blowing there? Dvandva. Meaning unescapable dualities of life. Joy, sorrow, health, ill health. Success, failure, gain, loss. These continuously come to us. No day is where you can say only one thing we experience. Something we experience positive, something negative happening. Something joy, something sorrowful. There's no end to it. Dvandvavata ahatanam, being afflicted by the winds of duality. Suta Duhitru Kalatra. Suta son. Duhitru daughter. Kalatra wife. Trana to take care of them. Bhararditanam. That bhara, that heavy responsibility is making him more afflicted because they are sitting on him. He is trying to swim. You do not know where he is going. No boat. Huge waves, so huge wind is blowing there. All of us are on him. You have to, Trana means to cross them over. They have to, he has to transcend them or take them also, transport them also. Sudaduhitrukalatra Trana Bhartha Bharartidanam. And the waves that are coming are Vishama Vishaya. The waves that are coming are all attractive things. Our Gurudev used to give an example. One fellow was walking in the forest and suddenly he found one tiger is just looking at him. It was his breakfast. And he looked at it. See, once it so happened, I was just there. One huge lion, just 5 feet in front of me, looking at me. I was so scared because it is eyes are so red and you know it's huge and you look at the face is so big and the hands and all so big, it's thick. One hit, that's all, you're finished. And I was looking at it, he was looking at me. Then I moved to the next cage. Don't ever think that I am a 5 feet near the lion without them. So once the cage is there, then you don't scare, get scared. So this fellow was suddenly realized that the tiger is looking at him and is ready to pounce. He started running there as much as quick as possible. He was running and running, sweating, and he was, that fellow was chasing him behind. And you are running and running. Suddenly, it's a boom. It's an open well. It fell down there. Dark open well. And he fell down there and it was a deep well. And he was falling down and he happened to hold a branch, I mean the root of a tree which was there. And hold on. And the tiger was just above him, looking at him. Below, deep water, you can't even see the end of it. And as he was holding on, there was a snake which was coming. Cobra was just about to start coming towards him. And because he had, picked up the root of the tree, on the top of the tree, there was a beehive. And the bees got disturbed and they were coming down upon him. He is holding on to it. It is a dark and the tiger is looking for him and the snake is about to bite him. And below there was water, I know how deep it was, and this bees were biting him everywhere. And his grip is going down slowly, slowly, slowly. At that time, because of that shaking, that honeycomb, from there one drop of honey was coming down. That is our condition. Even in the midst of such a sorrow, we do not want to give the pleasures of life. This is the condition of a samsari. Very sorry. It is a condition of a Vishama Vishaya. That's why Shankaracharya says Vishayam Vishayan Vishamivatyaja. Understand, the Vishayas are like a poison. But we cannot just leave it. Vishama Vishaya Toye. In that huge waves of attractive sense objects, Majjatam is sunk. Aplavanam with no boat. Plava also means boat. Aplavanam naranam, or those people who are that sunk in that huge waves, cannot get up with no boat at all. For them, Bhavatu Sharanameko, there is only one way they can come out. Vishnu Poto Naranam. I'm telling you, Vedanta and all, people listen to it and all. Next to moment, the moment they go out, they fight for the shoes. What happened to the shoes? Vedanta, chalaya. Vivek Vairagyam. You have become Vairagya of Jnana. Jnana Vairagya. Jnana Vairagya. One king came to a sadhu. Bhan, oh guru, you are so much of dispassionate Vairagya Purusha. I salute you. Then sadhu said, wait, I have to salute you before you do that. So that king was surprised. Why are you saluting me? He said, I have given up my house and wealth and the name, family and everything. But you have given up God himself. You are a greater Vairagi than me. I have to salute you. So when we are a householder, all this Vedanta looks very attractive, but then he says, Swamiji, I don't think it is practical. So for such people who are householders, there is only one boat available. Bhavatu Sharanameko Vishnu Poto Naranam. See, what does a boat do? What does it do? It makes you float. Is it not? If you have the, rowing, what do you call that? Then you can move. But one thing you should understand is, when the boat is in the water, it's better. If the water is inside the boat, it's a problem. Is it? Boat is on the water is good. Water is inside the boat means this is definitely a problem. You are in the world is okay. You are in the house is okay. But the house should not be inside you. Then there will be a problem. Gurudev used to say, even Mahatmas live in the same world where you and I live. Ajnasya vijnasya vishwam asti eva. The world is there for Ajna and Vijna. For the man of knowledge, for the ignorance, both of them, this world is same. But one lives in the world, another for in whom the world lives. So, be in the world, let not the world get into you. Our thing is very funny, you know. One person, he had a boat and then there was a small little hole into which the water was coming. You know what he did? So, water is coming through this hole. I'll put another hole in this, water will go into that. Imagine that stupidity. The hole from which the water came, instead of hole, plugging that hole, it's another hole I'll put. This water which is coming, it'll go into that. And then it'll go. Why I'm saying this is our problem. One thing we get attached to, detached from that, we'll get attached to something else. Coffee, I gave up. What are you drinking? Tea. You give up one thing and get attached to something else. So detachment is not replaceable. Attachment is replaced by some other attachment. It is not detachment. That's why in Tamil there is a beautiful, and I was also yesterday also quoting that. Tamil, it's a beautiful statement by Thirukkural. Patratran patruga, patratran patrunai patruga, apatruga patru vidarku. Do you understand anybody? Anybody understood this? Patruga patratran patrunai, apatrunai patruga patru vidarku. Meaning, you hold on to him who is detached from everything only to get detached from all other things. This is such a beautifully put there. So we must get attached to that which is detached. If we get attached to anything that is also attached, you get more attached. So when you are, some people get attached to the guru also. And make the guru get attached to them. That's another wonderful thing. So, when you are getting attached, attached means you get identified with someone who is not identified with anything else, who is detached, then you will be saved. Otherwise, you will be giving one hole for another hole you put. Oh, that also, okay, now another hole I put. That's finished, you are drunk inside. So, householders, it's very difficult for them to think, even think about it. So, here he says, for you to come out of it, you hold on to the boat called Vishnu, who is detached from everything. That's why Lakshmi also, when she came with the garland, he was the only one who was not bothered about anything. He is the only one who got married while sleeping. God, I'm married? No. Yes. So, Vishnu, boat of Vishnu alone is the great savior for you. Boat called devotion. Bhava jaladigatanam dvandvavatahatanam sudaduhitrukalatrat bhara trana bhararthitanam vishama vishayato ye majjatam aplavanam भवतु शरणमेको विष्णु पोतो नराणाम. So as he said, this is the most easy thing to do. आलस्यं व्यपनीय भक्ति सुलभं ध्यायस्व नारायणं लोकस्य व्यसनापनो धनकरो दासस्य किं न क्षमः. The path of devotion is such a joyful one. You know, there's no struggle, really speaking. There's no need to shun the world. Just keep the mind in reveling in the Lord. So that is why it is said, if the destination is beautiful, I mean the path is beautiful, destination is beautiful, you don't mind about the path. If path is beautiful, forget about destination. Moksha marga is so beautiful. There joyfully you can walk. Why unnecessarily struggle? Even you are doing sadhana, don't be unhappy about it. the face, you know, Swami Vivekananda beautifully said, if you are a sadhak, your face should be joyful. In the name of God, don't cry. Meaning, cry means don't be unhappy. Because if you are reaching the happy destination, how can your face should be unhappy about it? You should walk the path happily, joyfully. So, if the path is beautiful, why forget about destination? Who cares? So, the path of devotion is that, joyfully, happily, because the Lord itself is an abode of joy. Thinking about that Lord, you can never think of anything bad. So, that is the path of devotion. We'll see more of it next time I come here. So, we'll conclude today. Shri Krishna Sharanam Mama.
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 Sharanam Mama.
Sharanam Mama.
Om Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinah, Sarve Santu Niramayah, Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu, Ma Kaschid Dukkha Bhag Bhavet. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti, Harihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namah, Harihi Om.